Without the help of special equipment, no humans can breathe underwater, fly through the air, or float around space. But some people can accomplish amazing things with a little bit of determination and some help from their genetics. Whether through amazing feats of strength, incredible displays of endurance, and astounding examples of physical dexterity, the Hubs discovered people with the ability to accomplish 10 things most humans can't do. And before we get started, do what every other human is doing and click on the red subscribe button. Perfect pitch. Sure, you can get up on the karaoke stage and belt out your best rendition of Killing Me Softly, but it's rare to find a singer who can hit every note with ease. Perfect or absolute pitch is the ability to find a note without hearing a reference. Basically, anybody with this rare talent would be an a cappella group's dream. Unlike other traits, this skill can be taught, but it's best fostered in music students before age 6. If you're not already a piano prodigy, your chances of having perfect pitch are pretty slim, as only 1 in 10,000 are found to have it. But don't worry, there's still a decent chance you could have perfect pitch if you learned Mandarin Chinese as an infant. This is thanks in part to a wide variety of sounds Mandarin Chinese requires of its speakers. For example, the word ma can be used as an insult, a reference to a mother, a synonym for horse, or another word for hemp, depending on the tone in which the word is spoken. In a recent study, 14% of American 5-year-olds were found to develop perfect pitch as opposed to 60% of Chinese children. Facial expressions. Just like perfect pitch, you can train yourself to raise one eyebrow. It comes with less fanfare and no music ability, but it's definitely a skill that could get you some publicity. Just look at what one raised eyebrow did for Dwayne "The Rock" Johnson. Overall, only a select few are born with rubbery, flexible faces. And even with extra training, you probably won't be able to do every facial trick in the book. But don't give up just yet. The good news is, the talent can be developed by regularly twitching your nose like Samantha from Bewitched, or wiggling your ears like your garden variety bunny rabbit. After all, who doesn't want to be part of that exclusive group of the 1 in 5 people actually able to wiggle their ears? As for your tongue, 60% of the population has the ability to roll theirs, and the rest could teach it to themselves if they had the time. Folding your tongue into a clover shape, however, is an inherited ability, and touching your tongue to your nose, chin, or elbow is incredibly rare. But that's good news for any fancy dinner party hoping to keep any crazy tongue tricks away from the table. If you don't have any of the other special powers you're about to see, you probably don't have the ability to sit patiently through commercials. Well, you're in luck! We're announcing the Premium Network. With the Premium, you get ad-free early access to videos from Screen Rant, CBR, The Gamer, and many other top-notch channels. Just click on the link and sign up for the Premium to watch unbelievable content from your favorite channels. For free! You don't need to be born with X-ray vision to see how awesome this is. Synesthesia. Synesthesia is a rare condition in which musical notes are not only heard, but seen. They're also felt. Anyone with synesthesia can hear a symphony by Mozart, feel the horns and strings move through their body, and see colors, shapes, and images form in sync with the music. These unique visions are seemingly harmless and profound at the same time. Others not only hear music in specific colors, they also associate taste with the notes. Coming from the Greek phrase meaning to perceive together, synesthetes seem able to feel in a variety of ways, and all their senses are tightly intertwined. It's a hereditary condition that can't be learned, and it's more common in women than in men. Some scientists think that the neural connections causing synesthesia are available to all humans, but that this sensory ability is cut off as we develop. Outside of synesthesia, there's a condition called tetrachromacy, in which humans can recognize light from 4 different sources. Normally, people can comprehend red, green, and blue light, but tetrachromats can also absorb ultraviolet light into their field of vision. Instead of seeing an average of 1 million different colors like normal people, 3% of the population is thought to have this condition and can see about 100 million different colors. Immortal cells. One morning, a widower and his family got a call from a medical researcher telling him his wife was in their laboratory. That's odd, he thought, because his wife had been dead for 25 years. Confused and alarmed, the man consulted with his adult children, who reached back out to the lab and got the full story. This man's deceased wife was Henrietta Lacks, and 25 years before, she was diagnosed with cancer. Her doctor then took a sample of her blood. Although she passed away soon after the diagnosis, her cells kept on living and dividing and living and dividing. They would even get caught up with particles in the air or travel on unwashed hands, moving on to contaminate other cultures in other labs. Over time, there were countless labs all over carrying samples of these cells. The Hayflick limit, which dictates that human cells are expected to divide up to 60 times, was well passed by these special cells, and they appear to be on track to live forever. Dubbed Hella cells after Henrietta Lacks, her one-of-a-kind cells have allowed her to leave an unforgettable legacy long after she passed. Mental calculators. Mental calculators have the rare ability to do all the work of a TI-83 graphing calculator in their head. The best of the best compete in mathematical World Cups to prove that they have the top computational powers. But can it be trained? Well, any aspiring mathematician could follow the lead of Wim Kline, a Dutch mathematician whose mental prowess made the news in the mid to late 20th century. Considered an average student with no IQ to write home about, he grew into a Guinness World Record-breaking scientist with a full-time job at the European Organization for Nuclear Research. But his early start in math began by actually memorizing multiplication tables up to 100, squares up to 1,000, and prime numbers up to 10,000. Eventually, he applied his own formula to the memorization process and was able to multiply together any two numbers put before him. Like the whirring sound of a computer with too many open windows, Wim would mutter to himself in Dutch as he calculated until he came to the correct answer, often beating the speed of actual computers. Although the devices of the 1970s and 80s were much slower than that of today, it's still nearly impossible to imagine a man with enough dexterity to outthink a machine. Super endurance. If you're an athlete, hard work can get you far on the basketball court or the football field, but genetics can give that extra push to make you a pro. Take Eero Monteranta. He may not be a household name at present, but this Olympian from Finland won 2 gold medals for cross-country skiing in the 1964 Winter Olympics. Part of that was thanks to his lifelong training, but a big asset came from Monteranta's body chemistry. Born with a special mutation, he had anywhere between 25 to 50% more red blood cells than your average athlete. These cells have the distinction of moving oxygen between the lungs and the muscles, giving him more strength, abundant energy, and lasting endurance. This mutation was especially helpful in higher altitudes where the air is thin. When the muscles lose oxygen through physical exertion, a hormone known as erythropoietin sends a signal to the body to create more blood cells. Once the oxygen levels return to normal, EPO stops flowing and the body uses the new oxygen. But Monteranta's body never turned off the EPO, meaning his muscles kept running at maximum power. It's like using an all-natural version of nitrous oxide in a humans-only drag race. Super partiers. Rock and roll requires a lot of energy. Singers and songwriters aren't jumping continuous hurdles, running a bunch of yards, or making legendary dives and catches, but maintaining stamina in front of thousands of people takes a lot of guts and adrenaline. Oftentimes, famous performers will turn to alcohol and other chemicals to take the edge off of life on the road. The problem is, the years of hard living take their toll, and although their songs may be immortal, their lives are usually pretty short-lived. This rule seems to have an exception in the one guy who partied hardest. After getting his genome mapped in a publicized research project, Ozzy Osbourne was surprised to learn his DNA contained several genes that hadn't been seen before. Supposedly, his genetic makeup allows him to consume the same mind-enhancing chemicals that took down so many other legendary musical figures and leave him without a scratch. With a mutated ADH4 gene, he's 6 times more susceptible to alcoholism. He has an increased predisposition to chemical-induced hallucinations and possibly a stronger resistance to deafness. That explains why he's still able to hear after all those years of heavy metal. As Sharon Osbourne said, "At the end of the world, there will be Roaches, Ozzy, and Keith Richards." Cold tolerance. Ever wonder how Inuits could survive up in the extreme cold around the North Pole? New science suggests it's their quicker metabolisms. Even when not digesting food, their metabolisms are working at a much faster rate than those of us living closer to the equator. Add in the fact that they're regularly hunting, fishing, and moving around, their active lifestyles keep them warmer than the sedentary one you're living right now, watching this video. Interestingly, similar metabolic activity has been found in native Siberians. Yet those families who immigrated to Siberia more recently, they have a much harder time adapting to the cold. The same dynamic occurs in higher altitudes. Natives in the Himalayas have larger lungs and increased breathing capabilities, helping them deal with the oh-so-thin air up there. But the newer population of Chinese immigrants have a noticeably smaller chest size, by an average of 3 centimeters. By evolution standards, it'll probably be many generations before the Chinese migrants can match the Tibetans breath for breath. Until that, they'll just have to practice holding it until they can compete. Underwater eyesight. Sea creatures evolved without eyelids because there was no need to clear the eyes of dust or block out bright light when underwater. Us humans, however, can't see too clearly under the sea because of the curvature of our eyes. Not to mention the fluids on our eyeballs are so similar to water that light has a harder time traveling through our corneas when submerged. This lack of sight impacts everybody, except for a small population of humans in Southeast Asia. The Mokan people are sea gypsies who lived off the coast of Myanmar and Thailand for generations, diving as deep as 75 feet. The children can clearly pick small brown clams out of a seabed of brown stones. Their eyesight's evolved to be twice as clear as that of Western children, and it gives them a much-needed edge in their harsh environment. The crazy thing is, when on land, there's no difference between the Mokan's eyes and the eyes of Europeans vacationing in the area. Once underwater, Mokan pupils contract a fifth size smaller than the pupils of other humans, allowing them to see clearer. Surprisingly, specific training can allow you to constrict your pupils almost as tightly as the Mokan. Good news for anyone training to become Aquaman! Double-jointed. There's always some guy in class who can bend his fingers backwards to touch the back of his hand, but in reality, he's not double-jointed. Nobody is. He's just incredibly flexible. Actually, most of us have the cartilage and joints necessary to pull our heads, shoulders, knees, and toes in any number of directions. It's just that most people stop pushing and pulling their limbs in unnatural directions once the pain sets in. Hypermobile people are set apart from most normal folks by their ability to bend any which way without feeling pain. It allows them to show off at parties and gross people out the world over. Out of all bendy individuals, one of the most flexible figures around is Javier Botet, a Spanish actor who's recently cornered Hollywood's creepy monster market. Born with Marfan syndrome, which makes a person super tall and super thin, Javier can contort his 6 foot 6 inch and 120 pound frame into any number of positions. He was so convincing in his first Hollywood screen test that the actor, who's appeared in Alien Covenant and The Mummy, was mistaken for a puppet. If you thought ventriloquists were scary, you'd wish this double-jointed guy had strings to hold him down. Hopefully you enjoyed viewing the amazing talents a few of your fellow humans have within them. While these were 10 things most people can't do, we know all people can watch The Hub. To see what other crazy feats people are capable of, come back soon. We'll see you then!